Professor all, I am Disha Agrawal. I am a student of Government College of Education, Akola. So today I am here to teach you about physical science of class 9. So our topic is second law of motion. In second law of motion, we have to learn various definitions. So look at the first of all, I want to ask some questions to know your previous knowledge. So what do you mean by mass? Anybody knows? Tell me. Anyone tell me? Yes, it is the mass is the dimensionless quantity represent the amount of matter in the particles or object. Yes, mass, the SI unit of mass is, anyone tell me? Yes, kilogram. So what do you know about velocity? Velocity is the rate of change of position of an object. It is itself SI unit is meter per second. So good. Now tell me about acceleration. Anyone tell me? Okay, acceleration is the acceleration. Acceleration is the measure of the change of velocity. An object per unit time. Yes, acceleration is the measure of the change of velocity of an object per unit time. Okay, very good. Sit down. So now next, do you have any idea about force? Anyone tell me? Okay, it is a push or pull of an object. It is called force. Very good. The force, SI unit of force is Newton. Very good. When does a force turn into play? When the interaction between this object arises. Very good. Now, tell me about some uses of forces in your daily life. A force can be used to change the magnitude of velocity of an object, to change direction of motion. A force can change the shape or size of an object. Anyone who describe the force? Yes, a force can be used to change the magnitude of velocity of an object. Magnitude of velocity of an object to change direction of motion. A force can change the shape or size of an object. Very good. Now, do you know about first law of motion? Anybody knows the first law of motion? Yes, it is state an object remain in the state of rest for of uniform motion in a straight line and less compelled to change that state by an applied force. It is called first law of motion. Now, do all bodies have the same inertia? Anybody knows? Do all bodies have same inertia? No, different bodies have different inertia according to the different masses. Very good. Now, well done. Next, now tell me about second law of motion. Anybody knows? No. Okay. So, look at the blackboard. First, the first law of motion Now we introduce first law of motion. So the first law of motion indicate that when an unbalanced external force act of an object, its velocity change, that is the object gets acceleration. We would now like to study how the acceleration of an object depends on the force applied on it, and now we measure the force. Now the example of first law of motion. During the game, first is during the game of table tennis. First example is during the game of table tennis. If the ball hits a player, it doesn't hurt because it is low velocity, or it is a lightweight. And on the other hand, when a fast moving ball, cricket ball, hit a specific dirt, it may hurt him because it is fast throw. It is a fast throw ball. It is an example of first law of motion. Now second example, a truck at rest doesn't require any attention when parked along inside a park. But a moving truck, even at speed as low as simple, may like a perform person standing in its path. First example is, अगर टेबल टेनिस की बॉल किसी को लगती है प्लेयर को, तो कोई हर्ट नहीं करेगा. बट क्रिकेट की बॉल अगर स्पीड में आती है और प्लेयर को लगती है, तो वो उसे हर्ट करेगी. नाउ सेकेंड, द ट्रक इज डजेंट रिक्वायर अटेंशन वैन पार्कड अलोंग अ रोड साइड. बट अ मूविंग ट्रक इवन एट स्पीड एट स्लो एज सिंपल, लो एज 5 meter per second, में किल अ पर्सन. अगर एक ट्रक पार्क के पास खड़ा है और वो स्पीड लो भी है, 5 meter per second पे भी है, तो भी वो किसी की को हर्ट कर सकती है. ए स्मॉल मास सच एज अ बुलेट में किल अ पर्सन व्हेन फायर्ड फ्रॉम अ गन. दिस ऑब्जर्वेशन सजेस्ट दैट द इम्पैक्ट प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट डिपेंड्स ऑन देयर मास एंड वेलोसिटी. नाउ व्हाट इज मोमेंटम? Momentum is that if an object is to be accelerated, when we know that a greater force is required to give a greater velocity. So, in other hand, this applied this appear to exist, some quantity is important to combines the object mass and velocity. One such a property called momentum was introduced by Newton. So momentum is that if an object is to be accelerated in, we know that a greater force is required to give a greater velocity. In other hand, combines the object of a mass and its velocity. So the momentum p of an object defined as a product of mass into mass velocity. Mass is called m and velocity is mv. Momentum has both direction and magnitude. In the direction, its direction is the same as that the velocity. The SI unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. So now we get going to learn second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to the applied unbalanced force. In the direction of force, so we have second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum of an object is proportional to the applied unbalanced force in the direction of force. It is second law of motion. Now, mathematical formulation of second law of motion. Suppose of an object mass is m, its velocity is v, along a straight line with an initial velocity is known as u, and final velocity is denoted by v in a time t by the application of a constant force applied, capital F, throughout the time t. So we have initial momentum object will be initial velocity. First, p is denoted by momentum. P1 is represented by initial velocity. Now the final momentum object will be p2 equals to mv. In the change in velocity momentum is proportional to p1 into p2. The change in momentum is proportional to p1, p2. Now the W value p1 into p2 is proportional to p1 mu into mv. So we have m equals to is proportional to p2 minus p1. So put up the value p2 mv minus mu. Common opposite side common v minus u. Now we applied force is f. F is proportional to mv minus ये रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम इज अपॉन टी. नाउ वी हैव द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ वी माइनस यू अपॉन टी इज v equals to u plus a t, then v minus u upon t equals to a. So we have the value of v minus u upon t is a. So f is directly proportional to m into k. Now remove the direct proportionality sign, then we applied force constant. Now constant is equals to 1. So the SI unit of mass and acceleration are kg, kilogram and meter per second square respectively. The unit of force is so chosen that the value of constant is 1, that is applied force. The unit of force is kilogram meter per second square or newton, which has the symbol N. Okay, understood. Now we continue our next class. Tomorrow will be continue our next class. So write down your homework in your notebook to solve the numericals based second law of motion or first law of motion. First is what is momentum. Second, when a carpet is beaten with a stick, write down your number. When a carpet is beaten with a stick, does come out of you. And write the numerical okay. So our class is dismissed. So we will meet tomorrow and I will check your homework. So complete your homework. Thank you.